you just laughed it off, but it's all okay.
Good morning, Herrin High School. I'm Olivia.
And I'm Amy, and these are your weekly announcements for Wednesday, February 24th, 2021.
Congratulations to the HHS Flag Team. On February 13th, the team, along with senior Bree Parkus, competed in the IDTA virtual competition. We would like to congratulate Bree Parkus for placing first for her solo performance and qualifying for IDTA state finals that will be held on March 13th. The team placed first for their lyrical routine and second with their tall flag routine. Both team performances also had scores that qualified them to compete at the state finals.
This past weekend, on Sunday the 21st, the flag team swept all the competition, placing first in each of their categories. Senior Kylie Watkins and the team competed to improve their scores. Kylie again placed first for her solo flag performance, and the team won first place in both lyrical and tall routines. The flag team will compete March 6th in the virtual competition, along with the dance team performing in the palm dance category, and senior Emily Bacon performing a dance solo. You can log into IDTA.org to watch the competition. Congratulations, ladies, on a job well done.
From Ms. Frankel, Herrin FBLA competed virtually last month as part of their Southern Area Conference. They had a great showing with the following members placing in the top three of their respective events. Placing for Herrin were Patience Dorner placing first in advertising,
Braden Burris placing third in agribusiness,
Christina Yost placed third in business calculations.
Placing in business communication were Madison Varner was second and Brenna Guzwell with third.
Placing first in business law was Taylor Cornelius.
Kelsey King placed third in economics.
Bailey Hudgens was third in healthcare management.
Placing second and third for Herrin in introduction to business procedures were Amaris Williams and Keegan Weber, respectively.
Placing first and third in introduction to parliamentary procedures were Lauren McCluskey and Kelsey Bigler, respectively.
Maddie Geralds placed first in journalism.
Austin Shadowins placed first in organizational leadership, followed closely by Julia Moore, who placed third.
Alyssa Charlotte placed second in parliamentary procedure.
Placing first in personal finance was Alyssa Stallman.
The team of Reese Billingsley, Fox Connor, and Gavin Estes placed second in sports management.
Libby Brandon placed third in spreadsheet applications.
Fallon Ladd placed third in supply chain management.
And finally, placing second in world processing was Presley Carnes.
Your certificates can be picked up anytime in Ms. Frankel's room. Congratulations to all.
The math team kicked off its shortened season by competing in the first two SWIC contests of the year this past few weeks. In the first contest, Herrin had 9 out of the 12 competitors place. They are placing in the senior division, Kelsey King, 3rd, Jaden Lake, 4th, in the junior division, Logan Nitschke, 2nd, and Taylor Cornelius, 8th. In the sophomore division, we have Ella Reynolds, 5th, and Fox Connor with 7th. And finally, in the freshman division, we have Nathan Abba, 3rd, Madison Labatt, 7th, and John Braid placing 8th.
The following week, the math team continued with another successful week at the second contest of the season. Herrin had 8 out of the 12 competitors bring home a medal. Those competitors were senior division Kelsey King, 3rd, and Jaden Lake, 8th. Junior division Logan Nitschke, 1st place, top junior finisher in Division 3A, and Maddie Geralds, 5th. Sophomores Ella Reynolds, 7th. And finally were the freshmen Nathan Abba, 4th, Madison Labatt, 6th, and Sophia Camerato with 8th.
Congratulations to the Aces team who competed in the regional competition recently. Individual winners were Kelsey King, who got 2nd in mathematics, Cameron Champion, who was 1st in English, and Ainsley Farmer, 1st in physics.
Kelby Weber, who was double award winner, taking 3rd in physics and 3rd in engineering graphics. Jalen Blake tied for 3rd in physics, and Fox Connor 3rd in computer fundamentals. Congratulations to the Aces team, who advances to sectional competition next week on Thursday, March 4th.
The following announcements are from guidance. The guidance counselor sent out an assignment at Google Classroom for registration. This form needs to be filled out by this Friday, February 25th.
We will be offering the JALC AccuPlacer at HHS on March 25th at 1. This is for any sophomore who wants to begin taking dual credit / dual enrollment classes, any junior interested in a summer class or wants to enroll in dual credit English or math, or any senior who needs to increase their test scores to avoid remedial math and English classes at JALC next fall.
We will be offering ASVAB on March 16th at 1 o'clock for any sophomore, junior, or senior. This can be used as a practice test, as a career inventory, or this score is good for 2 years if a student decides to enlist. You have until March 5th to register.
Total Force Virtual Career Fair via Zoom is an event that allows participants to explore different career opportunities in the Air National Guard, Active Duty Air Force, Air Force Reserves, Special Warfare, and the U.S. Space Force. The virtual career fair will take place on March 4th at noon. This is a great opportunity for students to get a peek into the endless opportunities the Air Force, Air National Guard, and Space Force have to offer and to speak with recruiters.
Southern Illinois University's Army ROTC Department is hosting a Zoom meet and greet with us on the 17th of March at 10 a.m. This virtual meet and greet is intended to provide you with information regarding the basics of Army ROTC, as well as its many benefits, to include financial benefits that can be obtained as cadet in the program. They will also discuss the national scholarship process, cadet stipend, and Illinois state tuition waiver opportunities. The department chair and professor of military science, Lieutenant Colonel Jared Glassnap, will be hosting the event, providing his own personal story as a student and graduate of an Army ROTC program, as well as answering any questions.
From Mrs. Shelton, reminder to seniors that you are required to either file a FAFSA or submit a FAFSA participation form to opt out.
The Bowling Tigers have had a great start to their season, with the boys and girls team currently 2-0. Layla Wade met with the senior members of the bowling team recently to discuss the season, and here is what they had to say.
I'm Layla Wade, and I'm here with the seniors from the bowling team, and I'm here to ask them a few questions.
I'm Jalen Blake.
I'm Julia Moore.
Jackson Mansell.
I'm Dunia Crispi.
As rough as 2020 has been, how have you guys prepared for a season in such a short amount of time?
The day that we found out that we were going to get to have a season, we scheduled a practice for that next Monday, and we have practiced 7 days in a row leading up to our first match. And I think that we've had really good practices, and I think that's been pretty good preparation for a quick season.
We've just been practicing a lot, doing drills, doing the right stuff.
How has COVID changed the way you guys practice and play?
So at matches now, we each get our own separate chair, and we have to be 6 feet apart. And we used to just all sit up there by each other, and now we have to be like more spread out.
Okay. Have you ever bowled before, and what has your experience been so far?
Oh, it's my first time playing bowling, and it's so funny, and I like it.
Are there any certain matches you guys are excited or nervous about this season?
There's not really any matches in particular. We used to look forward to versing the Metro East teams like Belleville, Collinsville, O'Fallon, but we can't do that this year.
Are you guys allowed any fans?
It depends on the bowling alley. Herrin Bowl will allow spectators if they wear a mask.
What are your predictions for this season?
I think we have a lot of growth to do as a team. We are made up of a lot of underclassmen, so I think that this year we should really work on building good team chemistry and building a good foundation for whenever Jalen, Antonia, and I are gone. So I really think we're going to hit this season hard, even though it's only about a month and a half long, and try to get a good regular season record.
It's disappointing that we won't have any tournaments or any sectionals or regionals or state series, but as far as it goes, I'm glad to have a season.
I predict that we'll win every match. We have a pretty good team this year, not as good as last year, but it's also pretty disappointing that we don't have a state tournament this year. But for the boys, they're going to take two teams from each region and try to do like a state tournament out of that, which I'm looking forward to.
Thank you guys for joining me, and I wish you luck on your matches this week. Stay fly, Herrin High.
The bowlers are are in action tonight in Herrin and tomorrow at SI Bowl. Good luck to the bowlers, and we look forward to following your season.
Also, this week in sports, the girls' basketball team will be in Benton tomorrow night in Harrisburg on Saturday.
The boys' basketball team is in action this Friday against Benton at home.
Remember, you can watch the Tiger basketball teams in action on NFHS Network.
Next week, our school will be participating in the Great Kindness Challenge. We will have activities each day to promote our school and community to be a kinder place. Help us create a culture of kindness by participating each day.
Monday will be Miss You Monday. All advisory classes will send We Miss You cards to the remote learners in their classes.
Tuesday will be Team Up Tuesday. Each class will wear a different color that day. Freshmen will be orange, sophomore white, juniors blue, seniors black, and teachers red.
Wednesday will be What is Kindness Wednesday? Take time to reflect on what kindness really means to you and what you can do to show kindness to others.
Thursday will be Thankful Thursday. Take the time to reflect and highlight the positive moments you have experienced this week and the people that you are thankful for. Make sure to let them know that you are thankful for them. Thank you for joining us on today's announcements. Stay safe and
stay fly, Herrin High.
And air braid for life.
Like Wayne, what? Can you teach me how to factor? You know why? Because all the students after. All I need is a real good quadratic and for you to be systematic. So put those phones away and stop being a slacker. You know this is Barb and I'm going to teach you how to factor. If you got three terms and a plus in the back, I hear the class screaming like,
hey, this is whack.
Set up two sets, put an X in both. The signs in the middle will be showing up the most. The signs will be the same, so don't be ashamed. Because in my class, you're in the Math Hall of Fame.